Father, I think you should see this.
Enemies ahead!
Dragon. Is this one chained up too? More of those. Good.
Boy, over here.
Yes, sir. Another marker.
I'm aware of it, boy.
But it sounds so sad.
But surely not sad from all the roaring and fire breathing one.
About three chained dragons in Midgar. The shrine must be related.
There were three runes on the pedestal.
We've got to find the other two and three.
It does not concern us.
I know, but it's what Mother would have wanted. And it just seems right.
Guard your emotions, boy. Your enemies will not hesitate to use them against you.
Yes, sir.
No longer.
do.
Despite his failures. Another one here.
It's Scavi. Mother liked her. A great huntress.
That's right. Queen of the Hunt, they called her.
That's her father. And all the animals she hunted.
He taught her well.
And the last panel. Her father again. In the snow.
It's quite a story.
Well, yeah. But if a dwarf built it, it must have been impressive back when he ruled.
Whoa.
dangerous to destroy the other ones.
If it was your mother's wish.
Yeah.
You are too eager, boy. It may attack us, and we will be forced to kill it.
Oh. Good point. I'll be ready.
We will see.
Yes, sir. The Dwarf King made his subjects hunt dragons and other monsters for him? Some king, huh? Father, you may want to see this. Looks like that lever over there will free him.
He will attack.
I know, but it feels wrong to keep something caged like this.
Your emotions again, boy.
You can't hear their thoughts. I can.
Ignore them, and ready yourself.
Okay.
the beast thinking now?
Well, nothing. But he was grateful to die in battle, instead of rotting in a cage.
Your skill is improving. You fought well, Atreus.
Thank you, Father. Ah, fresh air feels good.
Boy, prepare yourself!
So, what happened to all the people who lived here?
Follow the clues, boy.
Right, right. Follow the clues. Okay, so there was an evil dwarf king, and he made all these people hunt monsters. The people put them in cages, and then I don't know.
We are missing a clue.
Back inside the castle?
There's nothing more for us inside. But stay alert for chain dragons, boy. Perhaps you'll uncover more about this Dwarf King.
Amir, what else did the serpent tell you when you spoke? Kinda sounded important.
I'm sure it's nothing. He just said the boy seemed familiar to him.
Me? That's impossible.
Don't I quite agree? Unless, perhaps, he refers to something yet to be. It is said that when Jormungandr and Thor battle at Ragnarok, their clash so violently shakes the Tree of Life that it splinters, casting the serpent backward through time, even before his own birth.
What?
That is madness.
Well, I did say not to concern yourself.
The statue stands no longer, Spirit.
Then my bond to this realm is severed, and I am off to find the real God of Thunder. He will know retribution. My deepest gratitude.
Off he goes. Brave God. Going to look for Thor on his own.
He is a fool.
What did the spirit leave us?
An offering to one of the gods.
Can we use it?
No, but perhaps the dwarves can.
Son of a bitch.
that down there. So what happened when Tyr brought Odin to Jotunheim?
Tyr always believed the best in people. And taking Odin at his word and his desire for peace, he brought the Raven King to Jotunheim. And we'll pick this up later.
So what happened when Tyr brought Odin to Jotunheim?
From there, things unraveled quickly. The giants anticipated Odin's trickery and exposed his true agenda to spy and steal their secret wisdom. What? I'll tell this one later.
Another name. Goind.
Someone who loved the Valkyries enough to do this? I wonder.
perhaps the Queen.
After Odin was cast out of the Odin realm.
With magics, they expelled Odin from their realm and cursed him never to return. Frustrated, Odin visited his fury upon the giants of Midgard. Thor unleashed Mjolnir's might upon any giant he could find. None could stand against the tide of slaughter that followed. And at last, it seems, with Tyr's aid, they retreated. The tower disappeared, no giants could be found in Midgard, and no man nor god has set foot in Jotunheim since.
Over. Torch is built with wood. That is a brazier.
A brazier. Looks like there's something written on it. Want me to read it?
Okay, here we go!
You're dead?
You're very perceptive.
Us?
Other spirits.
We have no desire.
But you all...
He disappeared.
Come, let us not be distracted.
One more for the collection. Thank you. I guess we should keep an eye out for other spirits.
What did I say about distractions?
But it sounds like they needed help.
They are spirits, boy. Dead things. They have no needs. Only wants.
It feels wrong to ignore them.
You will get over these feelings.
Mom would have wanted to help them.
What was that, boy?
Nothing.
I thought as much.
Something interesting.
Did you now? Well, Cullen,
Tyr would have been pleased as peaches knowing these offerings were being turned to armor.
Did you know him? What was he like?
Never you mind, boy. Tyr's dead. Best not to dig up the past.
The dwarf speaks wisely, for once.
I need that alchemist for something I'm stewing up for you. If you're smart, you'll find him.
Now, what was the other?
Why did you work for Odin to be so horrible?
It's my career! And if you mean to make your career as a counselor to kings, you can't very well rule out petty maniacs. Available positions are scarce enough. My first master was a cruel piece of work as well, but I learned through him the enduring power of wit, which served me well with kings and gods alike. I couldn't have been much older than you when I started. A fairy king's errand boy and unofficial jester. Or I can just tell you this story later.
Bothar.
Are you okay?
No, son. Hell, what? I was there. Thunderstorm scattered all three of my ships across the lake. I don't know when it... Look here.
Yes, sir. Another map. Great. Gulvig's bones.
What will you say to her?
To Gulvig?
Your mother. What have you left unsaid?
I just want to know if she's okay.
She is dead, boy.
I know that. You don't understand.
Neither do you.
Hey, another brazier.
I suppose you wish to light it.
Can I?
Boy.
Kvegia.
Quite a formidable duo.
I don't believe it. Are you both alive?
Another spirit.
Yes, another spirit.
Are you really there?
Or did I just imagine that?
Hello.
I can't remember the last time I saw something walk these islands that wasn't dead or corrupted.
What do you mean?
The desolation, child. Plagues this land, growing more severe with each passing winter.
Do you know its cause?
Not for certain, but I suspect the appearance of the World Serpent.
Do you need any?
Boy.
I only wish to...
tell you about offering help.
Don't.
Correct.
But can't we
this
just...
This is not a debate. You must learn focus. Our journey need be your only concern.
But what if they can help us? That one seemed to know a little about the lake.
And how does that help us with our goal?
We won't know unless we ask.
See, my first job. Right. Me and my mates in the employ of a fairy king. By night, my mates and I had the run of the forest. Good fellows, they called us. Knavish fights to the last. Get up to all manner of mischief, making fools of the local mortals. But as long as our lord was kept amused, we were spared the consequences. Then one day he was not amused. And I saw fit to move on. Thankfully, the ages and roads travelled since then have turned me from that merry wanderer into the paragon of virtue you see before you today.
We could beach the boat here.
Ready!
The final bone.
Yeah.
We might as well return them to the spirit. Maybe he will keep his word.
I know she's not coming back, okay? I know. I just... Never mind. I just gotta return the bones. Come here. How'd you come to be in these lands?
Lad, there comes a time in every man's life when he changes his name and heads north to make a new start. If you live long enough to do this many times over, you might end up as far north as this place. By the time I arrived, I already knew Odin by his reputation, and so I set to demonstrate my worth by coming to him with something I knew he'd value, a mystic well of knowledge.
You know what?
I'll tell this one later.
I wonder why Gudvig's bones are all over the place.
Desecration, typically. Pieces of scattered corpse make for a piss-poor soul. No hope for Valhalla or Helheim when your arm's on one beach and your head's on another.
Why not ask the spirit? I'm sure he will be forthcoming with answers.
Now, I believe I was just acquainting Odin with my mystic well of knowledge. I'm gonna pick this up for you.
We have collected the rest of your woman's corpse spirit. Show us this magic you have promised.
Ah, my sweet Gullvig. Whole again. Rise, dear Gullvig. Awaken, oh powerful Gullvig!
She says she'll honor our request.
And
reunite us?
In death!
Okay, you were right. I told you so. You are naive, foolish boy.
This is true as well. But do not take your disappointment out on me, boy. Take it as a lesson.
Yes, sir.
Now, I believe I was just acquainting Odin with my mystic well of knowledge. Or rather, I should say, a well of water laced with enough mystic mushrooms to make a god see visions. Oh, he was rightly impressed. Can't say for sure what he saw that led him to try gouging out his own eyes, but I managed to restrain him before he finished the job. Then I persuaded him it has been his sacrifice made for an even higher form of sight to be bestowed. Blah, 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 blah. I used to think he never caught on, but the day he took my eye, I realised he had never been fooled. He knew I'd outwitted him, called the lesson wisdom, and hired me to make sure from then on I was on his side. And for a long, long time I truly was. Doesn't mean he didn't hold a grudge.
This guy's part of his crew? That's a tough crew.
And all were his responsibility.
That's a lot of responsibility.
Does it frighten you? Responsibility.
No. I don't think so. I mean, I think it used to. Not as much anymore.
Why is that?
Well, being out here with you makes me feel more grown up.
Look here.
Yes, sir. Okay. That's going in the journal.
Go!
Another name. Runer.
Why the arcane runes? Perhaps we're meant to find something in Muspelheim and Niflheim.
Well?
Well, what?
The brazier?
If you must.
Atreus, here!
Yes, father!
Kvekia.
Well done, boys. Never thought I'd see a scrap like that again.
Got it.
What do you want?
To thank you. The...
useless.
Well, we can't expect them all to know something useful. I think this is the last one. Might as well, right?
Fine. Spirit who wants something from us. How unexpected.
What's wrong?
I came to this lake with a...
We cannot un...
I know that.
Is there anything... Oh.
Wait!
Deal.
Thank you.
You are learning.
Why didn't you or Mom ever tell me about the desolation?
I won't speak for your mother, but it was never my concern. Nor should it be yours.
Doesn't it concern us if everything around us is dying?
Our only concern is going home.
Really? Then why are we exploring all these islands?
The resources we find improve our equipment. If we stray from the path, it is only to prepare ourselves for the journey ahead.
I can live with that if it means we keep exploring. And helping others.
Focus up, boy.
Seriously. How did this one captain lead so many men?
He had their loyalty, so they followed.
And they all died. He must have been a bad leader.
Why do you think that?
Well, he led all of these men to their deaths.
True. But these men chose to follow. Even good leaders make poor choices. The best take responsibility for them. Remember this. Yes. I led men in battle.
Were you a good leader?
It is complicated.
Did you
ever... No more questions, boy. Focus on the task at hand.
Yes, sir. was another shipwreck under the water. Mimir, I still don't get why you ever wanted to work for Odin.
Back then, I was young enough to still be ambitious. The Aesir gods were as powerful a force as I'd come across, but they clearly lacked for strategy, focus, and sage counsel. I believe I was saying the Aesir had power, but lacked for strategy. All this could I faithfully provide. And so, a stranger from a far-off island found himself with Odin's ear, trusted as he trusted no one but himself. And with that kind of power, laddie, I must confess, there are perks.
Yeah, but he's Odin.
Or I can just tell you the story later.
Give him one more.
Enemies ahead!
That was the last ship. I hope the captain will be satisfied now.
Unlikely. He was determined to put these men to rest himself.
But he would have never been able to.
That does not matter to him. Our victory will only remind him of his failure.
Then, why do we do this? Father, why did you really want to help the Spirit?
You need the experience.
I've had plenty of experience fighting these things. What's the real reason?
This man inspired loyalty. He took responsibility for his mistakes, and he was determined to fix them. These are good lessons for you.
Oh.
Yes. Oh.
Where was I then?
You'd become Odin's most trusted advisor.
Aye. And we'll pick this up later.
My men...
That's right. We killed... We laid them all to rest.
I see. So even in death...
But in life you were...
Yeah.
I...
Well, you're right. You didn't seem very satisfied. I guess you know. Never really get over losing ones you care about.
Never.
Wow. It's like there was an entire city under the water.
Aye, lad. A forgotten city.
What was it called?
I forgot. was I then?
You'd become Odin's most trusted advisor.
Aye. I never claimed to be perfect, laddie, only clever. And often too clever by half.
So what'd you do to get Odin so mad at you?
Well, for a long time my job was to enable Odin, and I was fucking excellent at it. Gradually, as I grew more to care about people and the world, my job became to contain him. You know what? I'll tell this one later.
Scare up that alchemist, what needed finding? I'm sure that'll keep you out of trouble. Keep them from acting bits off you. Now, about that other thing. let's get to it. Right, we'll scoot then. I need that alchemist for something I'm stewing up for you.
You were getting to how Odin turned on you.
Well, I felt my duty to Odin had evolved. To protect him from himself. By serving peace, I served his interests as well. That's the truth. But he saw it as disloyalty. No longer trusting my motives, but not wishing to part with my brain or tongue, he bound me to a tree and adopted a new pastime of casual torture.
Well, I'm glad we came along to cut off your head.
Aye, lad. Lucky break that was.
Come, boy.
Okay, that's going in the journal.
Scare up that alchemist, what needed finding?
Can you read it?
Yes, sir. These runes read death inside. Guess we keep looking.
We?
I mean, I'll keep looking.
That's a soul eater. If that kills us, that's it. No Valhalla, no hell.
It does not attack.
Ah. Mom made them sound more dangerous than that.
Then do not drop your guard. Come.